God, what should be your answer? You should not answer. You should ask a counter question, where is not? The details in the next class. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Om Sadachiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam. Om. After introducing the subject matter in the first three verses of this seventh chapter, now from the fourth verse onwards, Lord Krishna has entered into the main theme of the seventh chapter. Not only the seventh chapter, the entire middle section of the Gita, that is up to the 12th chapter. And one of the central themes of the middle section is Ishvara Swarupam, or the nature of God. What is God? And what is the function of God? And we saw, God is defined as Jagat Karanam, the cause of this universe. And when we say Jagat Karanam, both the intelligent cause of this creation as well as the very material cause of the creation, which means not only God has created the world, but being the very material cause, God Himself has evolved into this universe. Therefore, the main idea that Krishna wants to convey is that the entire cosmos is the manifestation, the evolved form of the Lord. Don't imagine God as a person sitting in a place, but learn to understand that the very universe is the manifestation of the Lord. And when I learn to look at the very world as the manifestation of God, that vision is called Vishva Rupa Darshanam. And this Vishwarupa Darshanam not only requires the understanding of this teaching, but it also requires the inner maturity to learn to look at this very world as Ishvara's manifestation. Until we study this portion, our assumption is that God is a person and Ishvara Darshanam is coming in contact with a personal God. Until we understand the middle section of the Gita, our assumption is that God is a person, and we think Ishvara Darshanam is coming personally in contact with a personal God. Krishna wants to remove this idea from our mind, and Krishna wants to refine our understanding. And he wants to present Ishvara Darshanam as nothing but the maturity to look at the very creation as the Lord Vishwarupa, for which Krishna is preparing from the 7th chapter. In the 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th chapters, Krishna prepares our mind so that in the 11th chapter, we don't ask for the arrival of God, but we understand that God has already arrived in the form of Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Jalam, Prithivi. So thus, not only I should understand what is God, but I should reorient the mind to see the very world as God. When I look upon God as a person, it is Eka Rupa Ishwaraha. Krishna doesn't want us to confine to Eka Rupa Ishwaraha. Krishna wants us to appreciate the Aneka Rupa Ishwaraha. The entire Gita is aiming at Aneka Rupa Ishwara Darshanam, Vishwarupa Ishwara Darshanam. And Krishna considers this Ishwara Darshanam as superior because Eka Rupa Ishwaraha or personal God is subject to arrival as well as what? Departure. And therefore, there is a happiness of perception and there is an unhappiness of separation also, as given in the Bhagavatam Gopi's attitude. So, they have got a Viraha Gitam called Gopika Gitam. They were so upset because Krishna appeared and disappeared. And when Krishna disappeared, they cried. The only difference is they cried in raga. That is the only difference. When we cry, Shruti Cherade. Ruruduhu Suswaram Rajan. Bhagavad-gita children, I am not saying. Ruruduhu. Ruruduhu means what? They cried. But how did they cry? Adha avalukku namakkum vyathasam. Suswaram, melodiously cried. Because of what? Krishna darshana lalasaha. And because of their crying, Lord again appeared. Tasam avirabhut shaurihi smayamana mukham budaha. With a smiling face, Pitambaradhara Sragvi Sakshat Manmatha Manmathaha. So this beautiful Krishna appeared, all smiles. Again Krishna disappeared, all crying. We don't decry that devotion. That is wonderful. That is beautiful. It has got its own charm. But that is lower level of appreciating God. And therefore, Krishna wants to take us to a higher level which is seeing the very world as Vishwarupa, and what is the advantage of such an Ishvara darshanam, there is no question of disappearance. Wherever I see, whatever I see, sarvam Vishnumayam jagat, sarvam Shivamayam jagat, sarvam Devimayam jagat. This Vishwarupa darshanam is going to be presented. For that alone, Bhagavan introduces himself or God as Jagat Karanam. And then Krishna pointed out that this Ishvara consists of two aspects or amshas, amshadvayam. One is called the Paraprakriti, the consciousness part, the Chetana Amshaha, and Apara Prakriti, the Achetana Amshaha. The higher and lower nature put together, consciousness and matter put together, is God. And how does this God evolve into the universe? Krishna said, this happens in two stages. In the initial stage, it is one para prakriti and one apara prakriti. Then in the intermediary stage, the apara prakriti divides itself into eightfold ashtadha prakriti. Para prakriti continues one only, and then in the final stage, the eightfold apara prakriti becomes the manifold creation. And then also the para prakriti continues to be one and the same. And in this creation, wherever you see the changing matter, you appreciate it as the apara prakriti of Ishvara. And wherever you see consciousness, which you can feel in your body, if you have doubt, you can touch. And because of consciousness alone, you are able to hear my words. That invisible, inherent consciousness principle, because of which yena rupam rasam gandham shabdan sparshagishcha maithunan yetenaiva vijanati kimatra parishishyate. We saw somewhere, you know where? Yesterday. So that principle, because of which you are aware of my words, that invisible, changeless awareness principle is para prakriti. The changing body mind complex is apara prakriti. And then Krishna says, whatever is other than these two, that belongs to you. You can take it. Other than which two? Consciousness and matter. What is there? And this alone is symbolized by the Mahabali story. With one step, the Lord has measured the entire para prakriti. With another step, the Lord has measured the entire apara prakriti. And there is nothing else other than what? Your ego. That is the problem. Which claims, this is my body, this is my mind, this is my property. Therefore, Bhagavan takes the third step and removes that ignorance, the ego, to indicate that there is nothing other than God. This is the systematic destruction of jiva and the jagat. There is neither jiva nor jagat. Can you understand the meaning? Jiva means what? The individual you. Jagat means what? The world, your possessions. Krishna wants to say there is neither jiva nor jagat other than Ishvara. Tanu, manu, dhanu, sabu, kuchu, tera. Katakadana arati panni prasadam aindudom. But remember, it is a highly philosophical arati mantra. Tanu, manu, sabu, kuchu, tera means what? You alone are there. There is nothing other than you. This is the teaching which we are seeing now. Very, very important portion in which we are seeing the seventh verse. Mattaha parataram nanyat kinchidasti dhananjaya. Arjuna, there is nothing called effect other than cause. There are no ornaments other than gold. There are no furniture other than wood. There are no walls other than bricks. There are no waves and oceans and rivers other than water. Then what are waves? Vacharambhanam vikaro namadeyam. River is only a name. There is no substance called river. Therefore, the teaching is, there is no product other than cause. And the Lord being the cause, the world being the product, Krishna wants to say, the world is only a word. World la ella edutha ennaache. World is only a word. There is no substance called world. Then what is the substance? The substance is only the cause. And what is that cause? God. Therefore he says, Mayi sarvamidam protam sutre manigana iva. Just as the thread is inherent in the beads, I am the sarva antaryami. In fact, there is one name for Bhagavan, that is Sutratma. Why is Bhagavan called Sutratma? Just as the thread is inherent in the entire mala, without the thread, mala cannot exist. Similarly, Bhagavan is the thread inherent in the creation. Up to this we saw, continuing. Rasohamapsukaunteja. Prabhasmi shashi surya yoho. Pranavas sarva vedeshu. Shabda khe paurusham rushu. Krishna wants us not only to understand this fact, but Krishna wants our attitude also to change accordingly. Any attitudinal change is based on understanding. If you have got love and reverence for your parent, how does it come? The more you think of the fact of what all things they have done proportionally, in keeping with that understanding, I develop the attitude of reverence. Any attitude is based on knowledge. That is why when you meet a totally unknown person, what is the attitude that you have? It is neutral. Neither raga nor dvesha. That is called udasina bhavaha. Audasinyam. But as you move with that person, suppose you know he is a man of principles, he has sacrificed so much, he has done so much to the society, you read the biography of Gandhiji or any such person, because you have the knowledge, then you develop what? Reverence. You read the biography of Veerappan. No, fresh, hot, hot topic. So I can easily quote that. What comes? Blood boil. So if you don't know anything, you won't have an attitude. Therefore, remember, attitude is based on knowledge. As you understand the world, so you entertain the attitude. And as your understanding of the world undergoes a change, correspondingly, there should be an attitudinal change also. When I look upon world as world, my attitude is ragadvesha. But when I understand the world as Vishwarupa, the manifestation of God, then what is my attitude? Reverence. In fact, the basic teaching of Hinduism is reverence to the creation as manifestation of God. In fact, you can spend your whole life to develop this reverence Hinduism has fulfilled. You see all the prayers. Rudram, which is supposed to be one of the most potent and beautiful prayers. What is Rudram? Many people think that Rudram has the highest philosophy. No, Rudram is only Vishwarupa Darshanam. If you read the translation of Rudram, very interesting, you will find I do namaskara to Lord Shiva, who is in the form of mud, maddaya namaha, who is in the form of leaf, adile rendu leaf, dry leaf, and who is fresh leaf. You will find that everything in the creation is enumerated, and we are asked to look at everything reverentially. And when the sun rises in the morning, don't look at it as a matter principle. Even if you look at it as matter, it is what? Matter is what? Apara prakriti asau yastamro aruna uta babhrusu mangalaha. Ye che magam rudra abhito dikshu asauyas tamraha arunaha. I do namaskaram to the sun which has got red color, yellow color, white color. At every stage, I reverentially worship the sun. Knowledge can be gathered immediately, but attitudinal change takes time. Like eating food is immediate. And especially nowadays, people are so busy, they finish off a dozen idlis in 2 minutes. Eating is simple, but if the whole thing should be digested, it takes hours. Similarly, we have got a twofold job, understanding the teaching, and also bringing about an attitudinal change, perspective change. And this project is divinization of the world. This is our project. And when the world is seen as world, it will persecute you, it will disturb you, it will create fear. So the world as world will cause samsara, but the very same world as Ishvara will not cause any samsara. In fact, this is the first mantra of Ishavasya Upanishad, Ishavasyam idagum sarvam. May you learn to look upon the very world as Ishvara Surupa, Ishvara Bhavanaya Achadaniyam. Paint the world with Ishvara Bhavana. What a wonderful painting. Paint the world with what? Ishvara Bhavana. And therefore, Krishna says, what should you do hereafter? In the following verses, he asks you to bring about an attitudinal change. Rasaha aham apsu kaunteya. Arjuna, when you drink water, you just don't look upon it as water, but the very essence of water, because of which you are alive, that very essence is, remember myself. Rasaha means what? The essence of water. The very basic taste of water is called rasaha. That essence I am. And that's why in the early morning Sandhya Vandanam, we worship water. Apova. So Sandhya Vandanam Pandravalaki Nyavam Irukkalam. Apova idagam sarvam vishva bhutanyapaha pranava apaha pachava apo namapo mritamapa samradapo viradapa swaradapa chandagasyapo jyotigasyapo yajugasyapa satyamapa sarva devata apo bhurbhuvasuvarapa om. Apaha means waters. Apram apohishthama yobhu vastana urje dadatana. O waters, you are not waters, you are Lord. And O Lord, you bless me with that knowledge so that I will be able to look at everything as Ishvara Swarupam. In fact, that is my destination. The ultimate goal of my life is learning to look at everything as God. Therefore, aham apsu rasaha asmi, he kaunteya Arjuna, shashi surya yoho prabha asmi. I am the very light, radiance, the brilliance in the sun and the moon. Shashi means moon, Surya means sun, Prabha means the brilliant. In fact, this brilliance or light alone is worshipped in the most famous Gayatri mantra, which is considered to be the essence of all the four Vedas. That Gayatri mantra is prayer addressed to the light in the sun, the light symbolizing the conscious principle para prakriti. So, tat savituhu varenyam bhargaha. Bhargaha means prabha. Literally, bhargaha means the destroyer of darkness. So, I am worshipping that brilliant sunlight which represents Lord, because of which light of consciousness alone, dhiyo yaha naha prajodayat, that consciousness alone makes my inert brain into a live knowing instrument. So therefore, I look upon the sunlight. Sunlight shunna soap kip shulran nantikadengo. Okay, that is also Bhagavan. So sunlight and moonlight. Then pranavaha sarva vedeshu. I am the pranava. Pranava means omkaraha, which is considered to be the essence of all the Vedas. So Vedas are condensed at three levels. The first level condensation is Gayatri Mantra. And that is why it is considered that chanting the Gayatri is equivalent to the chanting of the whole Veda. You have done the entire Veda Parayanam when you chant Gayatri. And later the Gayatri is further condensed into Vyahruti, called the Bhuhu Bhuvaha Suvaha Mantra. So, Veda condensed is Gayatri. Gayatri condensed is Vyahruti, Bhuhu Bhuvaha Suvaha. And later the Vyahruti is also further condensed. And that is A, U and joined together becomes Om. So, Veda condensed is Omkara, and Omkara diluted is Veda. Just like you have got some condensed fruit juice, you know. Adukapra thannina vittu vittu vittu, you keep on giving to hundreds of people, only one bottle, but go on adding. Why? Because it's supposed to be the Sara. So, yo veda dau swarav prokto vedante ta pratishthitaha tasya prakritili nasya yaparasa maheshwaraha. So, Omkara is the essence of the Veda. Krishna says that Omkara also is myself. So, sarva vedeshu pranavaha. Shabdaha khe, and I am the essence of the all-pervading space, which is shabda tattvam. The sound principle is supposed to be the essential nature of akasha. So, I am khe. Khe means akashe, shabdaha. That is called Shabda Brahma. Shabda Brahma Mayi, Charachara Mayi, Jyotir Mayi, Vang Mayi, Nityananda Mayi, Niranjana Mayi, Tattvan Mayi, Chin Mayi, Tattvatita Mayi, Paratpara Mayi, Maya Mayi, Shri Mayi, Sarvaishwarya Mayi, Sadashiva Mayi, Mampahi Meenambike, Characharamayi, Shabda Brahmamayi. You are Shabda Brahma. Therefore, the sound you are. And Paurusham Rushu. So, you are the very manliness or humanness in every human being. That essential nature which makes a human being a human being, that essential nature you are. Continuing. Punyo gandhav prithivyancha. Tejaschasmi vibhavasau. jivanam sarva bhuteshu tapaschasmi tapasvishu So, prithivyam punyo gandhaha, the essential nature of prithivi, the earth, is its fragrance or smell. Among the five elements, the earth alone has got gandha gunaha. The other four elements do not have gandha. So, Akasha has got a Shabda Guna, Vayu has got a Shabda and Sparsha. Sparsha means touch. Agni has got a Shabda, Sparsha and Rupam visible. Jalam has got a Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa and Rasa unique. And Prithivi has got Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, and the unique one is Gandha.